really. I start making money again today, though.
See,
focus.
Hey, Patrick, are you creating?
Yes.
Have you even started it yet? Make sure, if I haven't got your practice list, make sure you get that. I'll have to put the formulas up on the board, so I'll have to come over there. Yeah, certain month, maybe the backside, so I'll get those up there now. Okay, today, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take a few notes today, that's it. Pretty straightforward, pretty easy. No, I'm today, no, no. So, we're just gonna do a few notes today on the next chapter that we're going to, which is chapter 7. And it's based on geometry. So that's gonna be the first introduction to geometry that's been in a long time. So, introduction to geometric figures. So, introduction to geometry. Now, the actual figures we're gonna talk about today, so geometric figures, we're gonna talk about lines today. We're gonna go through a bunch of definitions, all that good stuff. There is three types of lines that we're gonna talk about, so that's what we're gonna pretty much spend most of our time on. But we do have a couple other words we can discuss that would actually get us there. Like, for instance, we'll have to talk about what a point is, we'll have to talk about space, and then we're gonna have to talk about a plane, not an actual plane, but an actual plane, geometrical surface. So these are going to be our words we're going to define today. So we have a lot of vocab words today, a lot of pictures, drawings, that type of stuff. And then that'll be kind of it today. So it'll be kind of basic notes. It doesn't seem like much, but trust me, when we start getting going, when we start writing definitions on the board, we start drawing pictures, it's a lot. This next chapter test is radically different than what we've seen before. It is, you know, before I always give you a problem, you have to do some work and stuff. A lot of this chapter 7 test will be vocabulary. A lot of it. So you'll have, like, matching. You know, you'll have a vocab list, and you'll have some definitions. You're going to have to figure out which ones match where. Okay? So kind of multiple choice kind of a thing. We're going to have a couple problems. You're going to have to draw pictures and use a ruler and a straight edge and all that good stuff. We're gonna have pictures of where we might have to graph something on a graph, or something where we have to measure angles with a protractor. So it's a very different chapter. I kind of like it. It's a nice change of pace from what we've been doing. It's a lot more hands-on. Some people really like this chapter. It gives them a break. They don't have to do so much calculations all the time. The good news is you probably won't need to use a calculator for a while. So it's kind of nice. Get away from doing that. But it is definitely different. It's kind of weird. So your first attempt at looking at geometry. All right, so let's start with the first one. I'll put the first word on the board here. We're going to start with the word point. I know I'm going out of order, but that's fine. We're going to start with the word point. Okay, we're going to do the definition of these words, and then we'll draw pictures and talk about notation and labels and all that stuff. All right, definition according to your book for the word point. It is a position in space labeled with a capital letter. And I'm going to put as a side note, it is non-measurable. I'll explain, I'll let you write it down, we'll go through it. If you guys are doing that, I need to put some notes on the board for Patrick. Thank you.
electric, there you go, there's all your notes I think you need. Odella, Tiger theorem, the hypotenuse leg, altitude theorem. It's pretty much what you'll need. So Odella, calculator. Number one, simplify the radical on number one. Make sure you don't have any calculator, so you gotta do the thing where you find pairs and take them out. Number two, you have to do the leg altitude, figure out x, y, and z. Make sure you're showing all the work, kind of like the number one. Number three, square that number, so it should be a nice whole number in the end. Four, use the Pythagorean theorem, find x. If it's a square root, fine, leave it that way, but show the work how you're finding it. Five, figure out what type of triangle that is by using Pythagorean theorem. Okay, show the work so you know what type of them. Just guess. On the back page, also Pitola problems, find x. Use your calculator, there can be decimals, it's fine. And then number 10, draw the picture and find it. Okay. All right. So, hopefully you have this already. Point is a position in space labeled with a capital letter. The big idea with a point is like this. This is a point. It's an infinitely small object. We don't actually measure it, so I don't care about how thick the dot is. That makes no difference. It's not like a geographical map. Would like bigger cities have bigger dots? That's not the case. A point is just a position in space. So my point in space here is on the marker board. And we label it with a capital letter like this. So what you're going to have is you're going to have pictures where they're going to have points all over the place. It's kind of like a scatter plot if you've ever seen one where they just have dots everywhere. Those are points. And how they label it is they use a capital letter. They usually put it next to it. And how you actually write it. So let's say like in the room there's a bunch of points. And you're trying to pick the point that's on the front marker board, which is that one, right? So how you label it, this is the notation. So notation is how you answer questions. So in the room, what is the only point in the room that is on the front marker board? Well, this is how you write. You write point A. You actually write the word point, and then you put the capital letter behind it. That's the one that answers the question. So maybe, you know, like why would you ever do that? Why would you ever answer a question like point A? Because maybe on a picture, you have a bunch of things that are intersecting, right? Blah, 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 blah. And you have a bunch of like dots everywhere on the thing, and you have lines everywhere, and I'll explain these a little bit more here in a little bit, right? And you're trying to figure out, you know, if there's dots everywhere. And you're trying to figure out the dot that has three lines going through it. So there's one particular spot in this drawing that actually has three lines going through it. It would be this one, maybe this is point A. So you'd have to write, okay, point A has three lines going through it. That type of thing. Make sense? Like what the type of question I could ask? Okay, the big thing I'm checking for, do you know how to answer the question? This is what I want to see. Point A, capital letter. All right, we're good with the word point now. Now, points, infinitely small, we don't measure them. You need a couple points to make other objects. And that's kind of why we're going to go kind of in order. Now, one of the vocab words in here, bless you, one of the words in here, bless you again, is the word space. That's actually written right in there. Right? So we got to talk about space. Okay, space, according to your book, and not outer space or anything like that. We're talking about geometrical space. And this has one of the easiest definitions ever. It is the set of all points. I don't know why. That's what every textbook always says. It's very cryptic. The set of all points. I was going to explain it a little bit differently. Basically, that's the big, fanciest way of explaining that space is like... is the area you're in that has all the points contained, right? So, like, this room has space, right? There's a bunch of different points in the room. It's the set of all of them. So you wouldn't forget any of them. So that's space. It's a particular area. It is actually, like, space has three dimensions, right? There's length, width, and height. That's what gives you depth and volume and stuff. So that's space. But it's all the points in the room. We don't exclude any of them. And that's what we're doing here. It's a position in that area that you're in. So in my space, I have a bunch of points on the marker board. That type of thing. Okay, we good so far? Like the idea of what we're talking about? All right. Let's talk about a line. There is three types. I'm going to put all three types on the board. We're going to go through each definition, you know how to draw them, all that good stuff. Okay, so lines. There are three types. I think some people tend to forget that, but lines can come in different shapes and forms and all that good stuff. The first one is called a segment. I know the book sometimes, your textbook in particular, refers to this as quote unquote a line segment. Other textbooks just call it a segment. Okay? Line segment. We'll go through the definition in a second. That's the first type, that's the one we're going to start with. Second type. It's called an array.
Array or array?
Just array. Not a line array or anything, that's just array. Third type. Self-entitled line. So there's three types. Third one is self-entitled. So those are the ones we're going to go through. What I want to do is give you the definition of them, draw a picture, make sure you know kind of the differences between them. Start with the line segment first. Okay, a line segment contains two points and all points in between. Okay, it's a line that contains two points and all the points in between. That's the big fancy way that the book describes it. In other textbooks, like my geometry book, The Back of the Room, and some of the other ones I've had, it refers to as line. It's a line with two endpoints. Okay. The goal today is to look at what this looks like, to draw, make sure you know the differences. How would you answer a question if I'm looking for a line segment? The good news is a line segment. This is measurable. And you'll see why. Measurable. Let me draw the picture and then I'll give it to you. So give me two letters of the alphabet, please.
Z and Y.
Z and Y, okay. So we have two points, Z and Y, in no particular order. And all the points in between. That is a line segment. We'll let you draw that out.
Do we have to draw your stuff?
Yep, draw it. Measurable. Alright, now, if we're talking about like a segment itself and the idea of it, how you actually answer it, so the notation for how you write a segment. Like if I was looking at the board, like what segment on the board is exactly 12 inches long? Right, so maybe it's this one, right? This is 12 inches. Let's say we measured it, right, with a ruler. So it was measurable. The notation of it, you write the two letters, and you put a little bar. That we're looking at right here, that is the notation for the line segment. Because again, it is measurable. So, I should spell that right. You should spell it right. There's extra D in there. Measurable.
did that earlier.
Measurable.
Measurable. I put an extra E in it. Alright, so notation. So, YZ. Now, doesn't matter that the letter is in order. No. So, what's another way I can write that?
ZY.
Yeah. ZY, put a little bar above it. Now, the bar, having the bar above it means that it has two stopping points, the start and the end. Okay, there's no arrows, there's dots. That's why they explain this. Has two endpoints. Endpoints means it stops. Bless you. It ends twice. Does that make sense? That's why it's measurable.
So there's no direction.
No direction in theory, right? You can put it anywhere you want.
Unless they're trying to.
But it's just, it's got two stopping points, right? Alright. But that's notation. This is what I expect. A lot of people always forget the bars. If you forget the bars off, right? You forget to put the bars. That is technically not incorrect. It's not wrong. The idea is that when you leave the bar off, it's actually talking about the distance. So if I were to write, so this is like the drawing, right? You write YZ with bar, I'm talking about the actual picture. If I write this, I actually mean 12 inches. So that's the difference. That's just a very subtle thing in geometry books. That when you leave the bar, they're actually talking about the actual distance itself, not the actual picture.
Geometry is all shapes, right?
Yeah, it's shapes. That's why they have notations, and it's all drawings, and all mixing these all together. So, are we good with the line segment? Pretty easy, pretty straightforward. Again, rulers, you know, measuring tools of some sort, rely on line segments. You have to measure it at some point. I always find it goofy, like, right, that, you know, like the measuring stick, right? The ruler of some type, this is a yardstick. It's actually a meter stick, actually. It's not even a meter stick. So, it's a meter stick. These were just set by some random group of governing body for how long it needs to be.
What if some guy was just like, yeah, that'd be funny, let's do that.
Yeah, so I mean, this is just some default measurement. Why they use a meter stick? No idea. It's like 38 and a quarter inches long, 39 and a quarter inches long. It's just a random number. Yardstick for the U.S. customary system is 36 inches. So they do that. It's a yardstick. So there is a difference between a meter stick and a yardstick. So, which I always find is kind of weird. How I know it's a meter, it goes up to 100 centimeters. So that's how I know it's a meter stick versus a yardstick. But yeah, like things like, these are just random, but they're based on a segment, right? Where you see this height every day is where the door handles are on a door. They're 1 meter off the ground. So it's just, that's the default distance. That's why everyone always grabs the door handle at the exact same height. You can tell when a door is custom made when you try to grab the handle and your knuckle hits it or something. Like you grab the wrong way. It kind of throws people off.
And my car's definitely
the one. Not a car, doors. Like the,
yeah, like the handle?
Yeah.
It's like the motor
All right, so that is a line segment. Now, the ray, very, very, very different, right? So let me get rid of the definition here. So now we're going to move to ray, and we'll draw a new picture. So ray. It is a line that contains one endpoint. And continues in one direction without limit. I'll explain that. Basically, what that's saying is that this thing is non-measurable. Maybe I'll spell this one right this time. So that's a ray. It has a different picture. It has one endpoint, and it continues off in a direction without limits. In fact, I'm going to draw it,
and then we can take a look at it. So here is a ray.
Give me a letter of the alphabet, please.
P.
P. B. Okay. Another one down the road. Let's see. Okay. While you're write that down.
So a ray contains one endpoint, contains one direction without limit. So this is a picture of a ray, non-measurable, right? That, what does that little arrow mean?
Continues.
Continues, yeah. It goes that direction, does not stop. It's going to go through the floor, keep going. That's why it's non-measurable. You can't measure if it doesn't stop. It's in theory, it's infinitely long, right? Even though it does have an endpoint, has one starting stopping point. The hardest part about array is the notation, how you write it. So if I'm looking for a ray that is pointing towards the ground, that's it, right? That's kind of my array. The hardest part is the notation of it, because this is the part that people will get wrong on my test. When you write array, you have to write the endpoint for sure, and one of the other letters down the row. Because this thing could have an infinite number of letters. But I'm going to write one of the letters down the road, and the arrow has to face a certain direction. Now notice, does my arrow look like it does on the picture?
No.
No. It has to face the arrow above it, because again, I'm not drawing a bar, I'm drawing an arrow above it. The arrow has to be going above the letter it passes through. So like, if you look at it, you see, like, if I think about it, like, it's like an arrow, right? This is an arrow. What letter did it pass through? C. That's where the arrow has to be passing through. The B has the endpoint, so the dot is above B. Does that make sense? So if you switch the letters around like we did earlier, or maybe you write like BC, the arrow has to go the other direction now. The arrow always has to be passing through the letter on the picture. So that's why those notations I've written on the board are the exact same thing to me. They make no difference. That, for some reason, that really throws people off. Because it doesn't matter how the drawing looks. In the notation, you just have to have the two letters, endpoint has to be one of them, and the arrow has to pass through one of the letters it actually goes through. The endpoint has to be above the right endpoint. Okay, does that make sense now? Okay, for some reason, that really throws people off. But that's array. Rays, we're going to actually see rays in the second section. This is not a common picture until you see the second section, you understand why we use them. Okay, they're not measurable, though. We can't use a ruler with those. Okay, the last one today is called a line. Alright, self-entitled line. It is a line that contains at least 2 points and continues in both directions without limit. Picture. This line contains at least 2 points, contains in both directions without limit. So let's go something like this. Let's call this M. They have to have at least two letters on it, at least two points. It has to be straight, don't have any bends in the road or anything like that. 2 points, and it continues. So notice what's on both sides.
Arrows.
Have to have arrows. So when we do the notation,
MN with an arrow over.
Over both.
Two arrows over both.
Exactly. MN
two arrows over both. That is a line.
Now, do you think it's, is it measurable or non-measurable?
Non-measurable. Non-measurable.
So, it continues. So that's notation. Again, you can switch the letters around, that's totally fine. If you have that person that likes NM, that's fine, but you have to have the arrows both. The only one that you can leave the bar off the top is the segment. The segment, you can leave that off, and it means the distance, but all the rest of them, you have to have the arrows or the arrow if you're doing array. So be careful of that. Now, why I'm showing you these, when I'm talking about the point, when I'm talking about the lines, the different types, you need those two objects. Those two objects actually make everything in geometry, every different shape. They use segments, rays, lines, everything.
Triangles,
circles, you name it. They're using some type of point system, some type of segment system, or lines, or rays, something like that. That's what it's using. And that's the part that is so goofy. And I can explain for everything, even circles and curves. Like, I can explain how did they come up with it using these objects. So that's why they're incredibly important. I'll explain something very goofy on Friday about, you know, points and lines and stuff, which it kind of really is weird. I'll explain it on Friday, but these are the main shapes. Okay, we're good so far. The last one. The last one today. Okay. The last one today. This is called a plane. Is a geometric figure. As well as all the others. That's so you'll hear that a lot in the book. They're referred to things as geometric figures. But more important, it is a limitless flat surface that is way more specific. A limitless flat surface. It contains at least three non-collinear points. I know that is a tough thing to understand directly around. There's another vocab word. At least three non-collinear points to make a plane. So what I mean by this, a plane is a flat surface, right? It's like the marker board, or your piece of paper, or the desk, or my desk. Those are planes, they're flat surfaces, but they're limitless, right? That means they extend. So if you have a really, really strong imagination, you can imagine that a marker board extends lower, up, right, and left. You can expect your paper extends off the page. Your desk surface extends in all directions, same with mine. Those are flat surfaces. Now, why they say they have to have three points? Three points, so if I put three random points on the board, A, B, and C, these three points define where the plane is located. That there is only one plane that can hit all three of them. So there would be one flat surface like this. That's the difference, right? So, now why they say non-collinear? Non-collinear means not in a straight line. Collinear is in a straight. So like for instance, collinear with each other, like Dalton and Sean, you guys are collinear with each other, okay? It could be this way, okay? Hannah, Dalton, you guys are collinear going diagonal. But when there is three people that are not in a straight line, they establish a flat surface. So like, for instance, there's more than three of you in here. You've established a plane in this room, the floor.
This is ours.
Okay? You've established it because you're not in a line, and there's only one surface that you guys can all touch.
Okay, now, let me explain that, because that really throws people off. Okay, if you are in a straight line with each other, so let's say I put like C over here instead, okay? Now there's an infinite number of planes that can hit all three if they're in a straight line. Because it could be the marker board, it could be this flat surface going this way. That's it. So this is a different surface than the marker board. I could tilt it this direction, that's a different surface. I could go this direction, that's a different surface. So to make a very unique one, you have to put them not in a straight line. Because now when I try to tilt my like plane here, this is a plane, do you notice I can only hit two at a time? Until I put it flat against the mirror. Now I can hit all three. That's the only time. That's why they say it's very specific. Now, how do you think they name planes? How do you think the notation works?
Name what planes?
Yeah, how do you name a plane?
Like,
name it.
Like
plane? Not an airplane. Oh, like geometric plane. Yeah, how do you name it? What do you think? You talked about how to do lines, talked about how to do points.
Maybe A, B, C, and box?
Close. I agree with the A, B, C idea.
A plus C plus B. That's I was looking at that.
You have to write the word plane, and you put three letters behind it. They can be in any order you like.
So A, C, B, B.
A, C, B, it could be, if you have multiple letters, you could use all of them on there. So maybe this plane has a bunch of different letters. Okay? So you can choose a bunch of different letters. You can pick any three you want. You just have to put them on paper, and they can't be in a straight line. ADF. I can be in any order you like, they don't have to be alphabetical. But you just have to write three and put the word plane in front of it. This is the weird one, plane. The other ones were very specific. You had to use like two letters. Right? Plane, this is the one rare one. You can use as many letters as you want. You can use all. As long as they're on the surface. So I could put all ABCDEF from the marker, I could put that behind the word plane. When you did lines, you can only use two. When you do point, you can only use one. When you do ray, you have to use two. But plane is very different. Okay? All right. Any questions with the surfaces idea of plane? Okay, tomorrow, what we're going to really discuss, the interactions of these objects, what happens when they start running into each other, what would it form? We'll talk about how do we get those other objects that most people think of when they hear geometry, like circles and other shapes. And that's what we're going to be kind of going into. The first assignment's pretty basic. It's just testing your vocabulary knowledge. Can you look at a picture and tell me the answers that I'm looking for? Okay. So it's going to be testing whether you understand the words we're going to talk about tomorrow, the interactions. Okay? All right. Any questions?